I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am solving the problem of overhanging beam. This is a question. A beam AB, AD 20 mm long. This is the 20 mm long, supported by two indicated pops. These are nothing but the pops, 12 mm apart. 12 mm apart, carrying a uniform distribution load. That is, uniform distributed load is 60 kN/m. Run together with a constant load of 300 kN on the left, 300 kN on the left. That is A. 500 kN on right. That is D. The pops are placed that the reaction is same. The reaction is nothing but this RB and RC. The condition is RB is equal to RC, or both are same. Find the position of the pops and draw the SFD and BMD. Also indicate the maximum bending moment and shear force diagram. Now, this is distance is unknown. This is X and this is also X. This distance are X here. We don't know the distance here, but we know the total distance, that is 20, and this distance 12. First, we have to find out the x distance. In order to find that x distance, I will convert into a point load here. In above, I will convert this into a point load here. Point load I will convert here. First, I will convert a point load here. It is 300 kN acting downward. We don't know the x here. RB and this 12, 20 kN, 60 exactly at the center. I will take it out. 60 plus 20. They have given the 20 here. 60 plus 20 is nothing but 1200 kN. And next RC. We don't know the RC. We have to find out RC here. 500 kN downward. This is also distance is XU. We don't know here. But we know the distance between these two. It is 12. Therefore, it becomes 6 here and 6. The total will be 12. And the total distance now from this point to this point, exactly at the center, will be 10 this side and 10 will be this side. Now, sum of the vertical forces. I will go for the sum of the vertical forces is equal to 0. I will refer this diagram. Now, downward arrow is positive, upward will be negative. Now, 300 minus RB plus 1200 minus RC plus 500. Is equal to 0. RB plus RC, I will be taken as a minus outside. If you calculate this term will be minus 2000. Minus minus get cancel. RB plus RC is equal to 2000. Now we know that the condition is both are same. Therefore, it becomes 2RB is equal to 2000. Therefore, RB is nothing but 1000. If RB is 1000, then RC will be 1000 kilonewton, kilonewton. We got the value of RC here, 1000 kilonewton, and RB is equal to 1000 kilonewton. Still, we don't know the distance between this AB and CD. We don't know the distance. Now, we have to find out the distance here. In order to calculate the RB value, in order to calculate the shear force diagram. Now, I will take the moment about, taking moment about A, taking moment about A, moment about A. I will take the moment about A. This end is fixed now. I am referring this diagram. 500, the bottom. Now, smiling face, sagging will be positive, hogging will be negative. Now it is hogging. Minus 500 into total distance will be 20 here, plus RC. What is RC? RC is nothing but 1000 into distance. That is, distance is nothing but what, 12 plus x 12 plus x. Next here, this part, 1200 into this distance, that is, this distance is nothing but, don't consider 6 plus x, please consider this distance, 10 mm, that is 10. This part you have to consider 10, because exactly half 10 and this side 10. 10 plus RB is 1000, RB is 1000, this is 1000, and this is also 1000, which is obtained here. I'm referring this diagram. 1000 into distance, distance nothing but x, is equal to 0. Now with the help of the calculator you can find out this. Minus 500 into 20 plus 1000 into 12 plus alpha x minus 1200 into 10 plus 1000 into alpha x is equal to 0. Shift solve is equal to, that is, x is nothing but 5 mm. The x is nothing but 5 mm. This x is nothing but 5 mm. This is 5 mm. If this is 5 mm, because we have taken the moment about t in order to find out this x, we didn't consider this x at all. If this is phi, then this is nothing but what? This is phi. 5 plus 12 is nothing but 17. 5 plus 12 is nothing but 17. The total distance will be 20. 20 minus 17 is nothing but 3. 3 meter. This distance is nothing but 3 meter. 3 meter. We got the length now. And this is 5 meter, not mm. This is 5 meter. And this is 3. 3 meter. 3 meter. After getting the RB, RC and X distance, the problem becomes very simple. Again, I am rewriting. Again, I am converting into the point load here. This is used to find out RB and IHC and the distances. Once you get distance, again the problem becomes normal problem. Now this is 300 kilonewton. This is A and this is B. And this is nothing but what? 60. Exactly. This is already we obtained it. Exactly at the center is nothing but what? 60 into 5. 60 into 5 is nothing but 300 kilonewton. The distance is 2.5 from this side, 2.5 from this side, because we obtained the phi x distance. Now RB, we know that RB is nothing but 1000. Now exactly at the center. Now here it should be 60 into 12. 60 into 12. 60 into 12 is nothing but 720. 60 into 12 is nothing but 720. 60 into 12 is nothing but 720. 6 meter this side and 6 meter this side. And RC is nothing but 1000 again here. 1000 RC is 1000, which is obtained here. And exactly at the center again, because it is a UDL, 16 into 3 you have to do it. 16 into 3, 180. This is 1.5 this end, 1.5 this end. Next, now I'm going for shear force diagram. Now the problem becomes very simple here. Now shear force for this diagram. Shear force. Now go for naming A, B, C and D. Now shear force at D, there is no load, therefore 0, only single letter is there. Now there is a point load from the bottom, C, right side, right, the right is nothing but this part, this is nothing but right, 180, positive 180, because we have taken the bottom as a positive side, positive. Now this side, SFC at left side, left, that is but plus 180 minus 1000, minus 1000, minus 1000. Sorry, here I have missed one value here. This arrow I have missed it. It is 5000 kilonewton. Everything is clear now. 5000 kilonewton. again I will rewrite this part. Shear force at D. D is nothing but the point load acting, therefore you have to consider left and right. SFD at right side, it will be 0. SFD on left side, it will be 500. It is 500. Now at C, SFC on right side, 500 plus 180, it will be 680 kilonewton on right. This is the right. SFC left, 680 previous value minus bottom value, 1000. Answer will be 1320 kilonewton. Now at B, again right and left, SFB on right side, the previous value 320 plus 720, the answer is 400 kilonewton. Similarly, SFB on left side, this direction, previous value 400 minus bottom value 1000, answer is minus 600 kilonewton. At A, again right and left, SF at A, right, previous value 600 plus 300, the answer is minus 300 kilonewton. On left, SFA left minus 300 plus 300 is equal to 0. Now draw the diagram for shear force. I'm drawing the diagram for the shear force here. This is one more arrow here, 500. The first is 0, at A is 0, 300, at A only 300 it is, minus 300 kilonewton. And next at B, there are two values, minus 600 and 400, minus 600, 400 plus 400. Next at C, there are two value, minus 320 and 680. At D, there are two value, 500 and 0. Draw the lines. Positive, negative. In this way, I have to draw the shear force diagram. Now I'm going for the bending moment diagram. Bending moment. Now first, bending moment at A. It will be 0. If you calculate, it will be 0. Bending moment at A will be 0. Bending moment at B will be minus 500 into distance, that is 3 plus 12 is nothing but what, 15 plus 1000 into 12, 1000 into 12, 500 into 15, 1000 into 12, minus 720 into 6, 720 into 6, minus 720 into 6, Once again, I am writing this part. BM B minus 500 into 15, that is 12 plus 315, minus 180 into distance 6 plus 1.5, 13.5, plus 1000 into 12, minus 720 into 6. If we calculate, the answer will be minus 2250 kilonewton meter. Bending moment at sea. Bending moment at sea will be minus 500 into 3, minus 180 into 1.5, minus 1770 kilonewton meter. Kilonewton meter. And bending moment at D will be zero. Zero. Now I'm drawing the bending moment here. This is SFD. This is BMD. First is zero. At B it is, B will be minus 2250 kilonewton meter, and C will be minus 1770 kilonewton meter, and this will be zero. Now we have to find out the maximum here, because the shear force is getting positive to negative. When the shear force is zero, bending moment will be maximum. We have to check. First, we have to find out the x distance. Find out the x distance here. We have to find out this x distance. It is very easy to find out the x. This is x, and the length of this one is nothing but this part is nothing but 12 minus x. 400 is here. Don't consider the negative sign. You have to consider 320. X divided by 400. 12 minus x divided by 320. You will get the x distance. With the help of the calculator, you can find out alpha x divided by 400. 12 minus alpha x, bracket close, 320 alpha shift to solve, is equal to x is equal to 6.67 meter. 6.67 meter. The x distance is nothing but 6.67 meter. Once you get this part, you can easily find out the maximum bending. How to find out the maximum bending? That means you required the area of the triangle. The area of the triangle is nothing but this is 400, and the value of this is 6.67. The area of triangle indicate formula is 1 by 2 into b into h. That is 400 divided by 1 by 2 into 400 into 6.67. Now depends upon the previous value. What is previous value? It is minus plus minus 22.250. You will get b max. Now calculate here. Calculate minus 2250 plus 1 divided by 2 into 400 into 6.67. Answer is minus 916 kilonewton meter. That means it lies below the line. It lies here. Minus 916 kilonewton meter. Kilonewton meter. Now, because it is a UDL, therefore parabola comes in picture. Negative, 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 negative. This way you have to solve the problem when x distance is given. This is a very important problem in the PTU. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.